Hello students, today we will be doing excretory system in human body. Now what is excretory system? Why is it so important in our body, or why it is one of the vital system amongst the different types of systems in our body? We will see, we will do, and we will understand what types and what important functions and what types of functioning and problems and capabilities this excretory system or excretion prevails in our body. Do you know that kidney filters about 1700 liters of blood daily? So due to this reason, we should have our body hydrated all the time. We should take required amount of waters every day. We should eliminate bad habits like smoking, drinking from our daily habitat. Muscular exercise is one of the major factors which boost up the kidney to work properly, and we should have green vegetables every day. Hydration is one of the major factors which helps the kidney to form or filtrate the 1700 liters of blood daily, and other harmful chemicals or harmful byproducts are eliminated out of the body with the help of kidney and different parts of kidney with their immense contribution to the excretory system of human body. What is human excretory system? The function of human excretory system is to excrete or get rid of the wastes that are not helpful to the body. The amount of waste or the byproducts produced by different types of biochemical processes like digestion, absorption, and other processes in the body which may produce some byproducts. The byproducts means which are produced apart from the main process. These waste or harmful byproducts are eliminated out of the, this should be eliminated out from the body. Due to this reason, excretory system or excretion is very important, very vital in human body. As much as we keep our body hydrated, the more the kidney will act properly, function properly, and support our body to remain well in future. There are different modes of or means of excretory system with the help of which the human body excrete their wastage or harmful chemicals out of the body. The first one are the kidneys. The second is the skin. The skin helps to excrete our excess salt in our body with the help of sweat. The third is lungs. Lungs excrete the toxic carbon dioxide which is produced by the cell out of the body. The next is the digestive system, where the food is utilized in the body. It causes metabolism. The vital amount of protein, carbohydrate, and lipids are absorbed by the body, and it produces energy as ATP in return. And the wastage amount of the food is excreted out of the body through anus. The last is the respiratory system. The respiratory system or the lungs normally works as the same. It normally excretes the carbon dioxide or other harmful gases which are inhaled or produced by the cell out of the body, preventing the body from harm and preventing the body from different damages, helping the body to work properly. The excretory materials in human body are nitrogenous waste, excess of water, gases, and salts. In nitrogenous waste in our body, it includes urea, uric acid, and urine. Urea is produced by the byproduct of our body. Uric acid is produced as a byproduct of enzymatic actions in our body. And lastly, the urine, the excess amount of water, the salts, and some other harmful chemicals which are excreted out from the body as urine. Next is the excess of water. Excess of water in our body is excreted out in the means of sweat, where the excess amount of salt in our body is excreted via sweat glands. Next is urine as well. The gases and salts are also excreted with the help of these mentioned processes. Now we come to the detailed study of the excretory system of human body. The main function of the excretory system: the excretory system eliminates the non-solid wastes from the body. It normally non-solid waste because due to digestive system, we are leaving apart the digestive system from the excretory system for now, because the major excretory system involves the kidney or the urine excretion. Non-solid wastes are eliminated through lungs, skin and kidneys. Lungs exhale carbon dioxide and water vapor. Sweat glands in skin releases excess amount of water and salts. Human excretory system functions to remove waste from the human body. During this process, animals get rid of nitrogenous wastes product of metabolism, including ammonia, urea, and uric acid. Although excretory systems are diverse, nearly all produce urine in a process that involves several steps. There are different steps with the help of which urine is produced in the body. The organs which are included in this function includes kidneys, urethras, urinary bladder and urethra. We will see on to it, we will discuss and we will learn how the urine is produced in our body as excretory wastes. The functions of excretory system involves four major functions or four major headings. The first is the filtration. The excretory tubule. Excretory tubule means the pipe or the tunnel through which the urine is transferred. The excretory tubule collects filtrate from the blood, water and solutes are forced by blood pressure across the selectively permeable membranes of a cluster of capillaries and into the excretory tubule. The blood pressure helps the urine or the toxicated blood to rush themselves through the kidney pipe or the major tunnel through which it surpasses a semi-permeable membrane or selectively permeable membrane. This selectively permeable membranes are membrane which normally have a semi-permeability through which osmosis takes place. Next one is reabsorption. The transport epithelium reclaims valuable substances from the filtrate and returns them. We will see onto it, we will learn with the help of a diagrammatic review. The next is the secretion. Other substances are secreted from the body from body fluids and added to the contents of the excretory tubule. Other parts of the body accumulates all the other harmful chemicals or toxic materials to the kidney, so that the kidney can filtrate and excrete the harmful molecules out of the body. The last is the excretion. The filtrate leaves the system and the body. The filtrate leaves the system and surpasses with the help of urine formation. This is a diagrammatic view of the human excretory system, which includes kidney, the main aorta with the help of which urine is surpasses. It carries the purified purified blood to the other parts of the body. The renal vein, which carries the deoxygenated unimpurified blood to the kidney. Ureter, which carries the urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder. Vena cava, same as the veins. And urethra, which ultimately releases the urine from the body from inside the body to outside the body, and the bladder, which stores the urine for a while. This is the structure of the excretory system. This system consists of specialized structures and capillary networks that assist in the excretory process. The human excretory system includes the kidney and its functional unit, the nephron. Nephron is the functional unit of kidney, which ultimately actually filtrate the urine or the blood and excrete the harmful chemicals or the toxic molecules out of the body as urine. The excretory activity of the kidney is changed by specialized hormones that regulate the amount of absorption with the nephron. This is why the nephron is working properly. The nephron is working properly because hormones are repeatedly activating the kidney and repeatedly monitoring the kidney so that the kidney is working properly, like adrenocorticotropic hormone, which is normally one of the major hormone which helps the kidney to work properly. Now the excretory system or the kidney includes the kidney, ureters, urethra and bladder. Meatus means the medieval structure which surpasses the blood and the urine. The excretion in human, the urinary system is the main excretory system of the human body. It consists of kidneys, ureters, urinary bladder and urethra. The parts and functions of excretory systems are kidney, normally which I have discussed earlier. Each kidney is made up of the outer cortex and inner medulla. It is made up of million tiny filtering units called nephron. We will come on to it. Functions: the blood brings the waste to the kidney through renal artery. Nephrons purify the blood. Clean blood flows out of the kidney through the renal vein. Ureters: the ureters arise from the both the kidney and connects the urethra. It connects the urine from the kidney. Urinary bladder: it stores the urine, as we have discussed earlier in the picture. Urethra: a small tube that carries urine from the bladder and expels it outside. This is the entire phenomenon of the excretory system, from the kidney to the excretion of the urine. Okay. This is the diagrammatic view of the kidney. If a short note comes on the excretory system of human body or the human excretory system, this diagram is a must drawing diagram, which will be included with the number of points which would be written by you. And this is the diagram which is necessary for fetching marks in the short notes. We will study in detail about the structure of the ureters. Ureter is one of the major structure of the excretory system or the total phenomena. Ureters: a tube approximately about 6 to 7 inches long attached to each kidney, made up of three layers of tissue. The first layer is the smooth muscle, the second layer is the fibrous tissue, and the third one is the mucus layer. Mucus layer means it is a fluid or a very slimy layer present underneath the muscle. Peristalsis means a rhythmic contraction of the ureter's smooth muscle, which helps to move the urine from the bladder into the bladder. Okay. Ureter normally passes the urine from the kidney to the urinary bladder, where the urinary bladder store the urine and then passes on to the urethra. The urethra ultimately excretes the urine out of the body. Now we have to see the flow of the urine. First, the intoxicated blood comes to the kidney. The unit of kidney is nephron. These nephrons are the small units which minutely filtrates the excretory urine or the blood and separates the original or the non-toxicated purified blood and the urine which is excreted out of the body. The purified blood is circulated throughout the other parts of the body, gains all the oxygens and again gets toxicated and again comes to the kidney. It gets filtrated, the purified blood again circulate to the body or go directly to the heart, and the other toxic molecules or the fluid is excreted out of the body. Now we have to see that first the urine is reaching the kidney. The kidney have the nephrons. Now then, this is very important that the parts of the nephron which are included in the filtration. The first is the glomerulus, which then passes the blood to the renal tubules, then to the renal pelvis, then renal calyx, and then to the ureters. Okay, we will come on to the next structures of the nephron and kidneys in details. This is very important that we have to know the parts of the kidney. The part of the kidney includes three major divisions. The first is the cortex, the outer protective portion of the kidney or the outer shield of the kidney. Next is the medulla, the inner soft portion or the fleshy portion of the kidney, and the hilum. The hilum is a depression located in the middle of the concave side of the kidney. Concave means the undulating side of the kidney, where the blood vessels, nerves and the ureters enters and exits the kidney. In the diagram you can see the part of the hilum where the veins and the ureters enters and exit the kidney. The cortex is where the blood is filtrated. The medulla contain the collecting ducts which carry or filtrate to the pelvis. The pelvis or the broad portion of the ureter, okay. The pelvis is the hollow cavity where the urine accumulates and drains into the ureter. The brown portion where the ureter is coming and exiting from the kidney, that portion is the pelvis, where the urine purified or the non-purified, the toxic material is stored over there, which is transferred to the ureter and then transferred to the urinary bladder, and gradually the excretion happens. This is the diagrammatic view of the kidney. In the short notes, these are the major diagram which should be included in the short note and the broad questions where it asked for the, where the board or the, where the examinee ask for the diagrammatic view of the kidney. This is the actual diagrammatic view of the kidney. The left hand side is the covered kidney structure and the right hand side is the dissected kidney structure, where the different parts of the kidney is revealed. This is the major part where we will talk about, we will learn about the unit of kidney, that is the nephrons. The main structural and functional unit of kidney is nephron. Nephron consists of tubules. Nephron filters blood and form urine. Then this urine passes through tubules into renal pelvis. Renal pelvis is near the exit of the kidney. After it, urine goes to the ureter. Now this, the nephron is the main functional unit of the structural and functional unit of kidney, because this is the major portion where the urine or the blood is filtrated. The nephron consists of different structures or different portions like glomerulus, proximal convoluted tubule, Bowman's capsule, afferent arteriole, distal convoluted tubule, loop of Henle, collecting tubule, and different parts. We will learn, we will talk about it. Now this is the introduction of the nephrons. Now how does this nephron works? The first is the glomerular filtration. It is divided into three steps: glomerular filtration, tubular reabsorption, and tubular secretion. We will come onto it in details. Firstly, the toxicated blood enters the cortical radial arteries. See in the diagram, the cortical radiate arteries, the impure blood comes here. It surpasses the afferent arterial and enters the Bowman's capsule or the glomerular capillaries. With the help of the glomerular capillaries, the broad artery or the afferent arterioles are subdivided into tiny vessels. Now the impure blood is carries on osmosis with the help of semi-permeable or selectively permeable membrane, where the impurities are absorbed or osmotized to the Bowman's capsule or the Bowman's capsule. Okay, here comes the glomerular filtration. The water and solutes smaller than proteins are forced through the capillary walls and pores of the glomerular capsule into the renal tubule. With the help of the pores, the impure molecules or the water or the solid portions are extracted to the Bowman's capsule. Now these impurities are carried down. Now comes the in the rest of the renal tubule, which is distal convoluted tubule. Okay, now here comes the tubular reabsorption. The tubule consists of distal convoluted tubule, proximal convoluted tubule, and loop of Henle. This portion consists or functions the tubular reabsorption, where the water, glucose, amino acids, and other ions are transported out of the filtrate into the tubular cells and then enter the capillaries. Because water, glucose, amino acids are essential in our body, this is why these essential molecules are reabsorbed in the capillaries or the peritubular capillaries. Here in the diagram you can see the peritubular capillaries, the red arrow. The in the tubular reabsorption, the water and the glucose is again getting back to the peritubular capillaries, and the remaining toxic molecules or the toxic fluid is again transferred to the tubular section or the next part of the renal tubule, where the tubular secretion, where the creatinine and drugs are removed from the peritubular blood and secreted by the tubule cells into the filtrate, like hydrogen or potassium like ions, which are refiltered with the help of this permeable membranes, again come to the renal tubule, and ultimately the filtration is processed, the filtration is completed, then the fluid is transferred as urine. Now this is a very rigid or the very detailed view of the nephron. Here the first part is the glomerular filtration, where the glomerulus and the glomerular capsules are present. The toxicated blood is reabsorbing by the renal tubule. The tubular reabsorption, it consists of proximal convoluted tubule, where again the water and the glucose molecule are reabsorbed in the capillaries because they are essential in the body, and the excess amount of water or the excretory material is then passed to the loop of Henle or loop of nephron. Then it is transferred to the distal convoluted tubule, where the tubular secretion is taking place, where the ions and hydrogens are excreted out, and other reabsorption, last phase of filtration, where the essential molecules are reabsorbed by the body and the toxic material is out of the nephron with the help of collecting tubule, then surpasses the urinary bladder. Okay, this is the diagram of nephron, essential for the short note and broad questions requiring this type of diagram. This is the actual diagram which will be given by the students in their exam sheets. Now the functions of kidney. Now this is a very easy way to remember the function of kidney. We have to remember a phrase, a wet bed. How is it happening? Let's have a look. A for maintaining acid balance or acid base balance, W for maintaining water balance, E for electrolyte balance. Electrolyte means ions, hydrogen, sodium, potassium, hydrogen, any type of electrolyte balance. T for toxin removal, B for blood pressure control, ई फॉर मेकिंग इरेथ्रोपोएटिन. इरेथ्रोपोएटिन मीन्स इट हेल्प्स द बॉडी टू रिजुविनेट और हाइड्रेटेड. डी फॉर विटामिन डी मेटाबॉलिज्म, इट हेल्प्स इन विटामिन डी मेटाबॉलिज्म. नाउ दिस इज द एंटायर अ वेट बेड. इट इंक्लूड्स द ईच एंड एवरी फंक्शंस ऑफ द किडनी प्रिवेलिंग इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी. Now we comes to the production of urine. We have to first know the composition of urine. It consists of 95% of water, and others are urine, which includes ammonia, sulfate, phosphate, chloride, magnesium, calcium, potassium, sodium, creatinine, uric acid and urea. These includes the 5%, and the other 95% includes the water. Now the production of urine includes three major steps. First the ultrafiltration, next selective reabsorption, and then secretion. We have discussed earlier, this is the whole process of the nephron filtration. Now we have to know that what is osmoregulation. Osmoregulation in biology maintains by an organism of an internal balance between water and dissolved materials regardless of the environmental condition. Now what is osmoregulation? It is majorly or basically the control of water loss in the animals. Now the amount of urine we are excreting out of the body, that amount of water we should be taking every day. Okay. Now this is a cycle. The amount of water we are taking in, the amount of urine we are excreting out, this is a balance. If we excrete about 7 liters of urine per day, or total we consume 3 liters and we excrete about 1.5 liters, then we should be hydrating our body in a very large amount. Now why osmoregulation is important? All organisms must maintain homeostasis in order to live. Homeostasis means it by shrinking and swelling of cell. In absence of water, the cell will shrink, and in excess of water, the cell will face a flaccid condition where the cell will burst by swelling. So we have to maintain a regulation, a osmotic regulation or the hydration regulation within our body to maintain the entire cycle. This is the entire process of osmoregulation. In the right hand side, if we take high amount of water or urine output, and in the left hand side, when the cycle is having a low phase. Okay. In the right hand side, if we see that water content in the blood is normal, if we take too much of water, the brain will signal that the body is having too much of water. So adrenaline hormone is produced in a less amount according to the water, with respect to the water what we have taken. Low volume of water reabsorbed by the kidney, urine output is high. Large volume of diluted urine, where the urine is not properly filtrated, because our body is habituated in a certain regulation. If we take a high amount of water or drink huge amount of water than normal body can intake, the brain cannot work properly. The adrenaline hormone cannot work properly. It cannot signal the kidney that the body have taken a huge amount of water. So the urine get diluted, or the filtration is not proper. Similarly, if we take low amount of water, similarly with respect to the intake of water, the adrenaline hormone is more. So the adrenaline hormone will produce high volume of water reabsorbed by the kidney. So the urine output is low, small amount of concentrated urine. Okay. Now according to the excretory system of our body, we should know also aware of the causes of chronic renal failure or chronic kidney failure. The kidney failure includes some of the causes includes chronic infection, some infections in the kidney, renal obstruction like prolonged not intaking of water or excess intaking of water, or normally not hydrating the body, exposure to toxic chemicals, toxins or drugs, diabetes, hypertension, nephrosclerosis, it normally it's a problem in the renal artery, डायबिटिक नेफ्रोपैथी, नॉर्मली विद फॉर डायबिटीज हाई अमाउंट ऑफ ग्लूकोज इज प्रोड्यूस्ड, इट डैमेज द किडनी और द किडनी वेसल्स इज सराउंडेड विद द ग्लूकोज और शुगर मॉलिक्यूल्स आर डिपोजिटेड विद इन द फाइन ट्यूब्स ऑफ द किडनी सो दैट दिस हेल्प दिस इनहिबिट्स द किडनी टू फिल्टर द यूरिन. नेक्स्ट इज द इनहेरिटेड डिसऑर्डर्स लाइक किडनी प्रॉब्लम्स और जेनेटिक प्रॉब्लम्स, पॉलिसिस्टिक किडनी डिजीज. इन दिस केस डिफरेंट अमाउंट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट साइजेस ऑफ सिस्ट्स और ट्यूमर्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड ऑल ओवर द किडनी. इट इनहिबिट्स द किडनी टू फिल्टर द यूरिन. नेक्स्ट इज द इंटेस्टिनल नेफ्राइटिस और पाइलोनफ्राइटिस. इट्स नॉर्मली नेफ्राइटिस विच वेर द इंटेस्टिनल वॉल और द नेफ्राइटिक कनेक्शन इज ब्लॉक्ड बाई एनी डिफॉल्ट. दिस इज द कॉज ऑफ नेफ्राइटिस. द सिम्टम्स ऑफ क्रॉनिक रेनल फेल्यूर इंक्लूड्स अंटिल वेरी kidney function remains, chronic renal failure may not get developed. Okay, anemia, increased level of phosphates in the blood are complication of kidney failure, malaise or intake of drugs, dry skin, malaise means urinary problem, dry skin, poor appetite, vomiting, bone pain, metallic taste in mouth, like when we have fever it cause metallic taste in mouth, detectable abdominal mass in ultrasonography it may show some abnormalities or extra features in kidney which detect the kidney failure. Now due to this reason we should continuously hydrate our body. We should have normal amount of water or required amount of water every day, and this kidney is one of the major organ of our body. Due to this reason World Kidney Day we celebrate in 8th of March every year. And thank you. If you like my video, please like and subscribe my channel and do have a look on my other videos. Thank you.